In our ongoing coverage of the Fox News versus Trump war that's been going on for several months, we've given credit to Shep Smith, who has now transitioned out of the network, and Chris Wallace, even occasionally Steve Doocy, for acknowledging reality, even if it's inconvenient for the president. But it turns out that a little while back, Neil Cavuto had a pretty amazing takedown of the president that thankfully is being spread once again. So I want to show you some sections and give a little bit of credit to Cavuto for this.
Who likes to be corrected? But you are the president. It comes with the job, just like checking what you say and do comes with my job. After all, I'm not the one who said tariffs are a wonderful thing. You are. Just like I'm not the one who said Mexico would pay for the wall. You did. Just like I'm not the one who claimed that Russia didn't meddle in the 2016 election. You did. Now, I'm sorry you don't like these facts being brought up, but they are not fake because I did. What would be fake is if I never did. If I ignored all the times you said you loved your old Secretary of State, Rex Tillerson, until you didn't. Had no plans to dump your Homeland Security Secretary until you did. Called Chinese President Xi Jinping an enemy just last week and a great leader this week. Sometimes you don't even wait that long. Last week, you expressed an appetite for background checks before arguing just hours later, our background checks are already strong. These aren't fake items, they're real items, and you really said them.
Okay, so it actually goes on for longer, but there's a limit to how long we can play videos for, honestly. This is from a little bit ago. That's as critical as I've ever seen on Fox News.
It's because
that's as critical as I generally am.
Yeah, it was a part of the ongoing onslaught, not ongoing, but I guess partial onslaught that Trump has had for Fox News, because there haven't been completely, every voice hasn't been completely on board, as you mentioned, Shep Smith also gone. Mm-hmm. So that was like finally, you eventually get fed up and you have to say some truth that you've been holding your tongue about. It also illustrates they really, many of these voices there, they know what's happening, they know it's ridiculous, and until they are forced to say it, they won't.
Yeah. Yeah, the interesting thing is I don't follow Cavuto. So I don't know if this is a thing that he occasionally does. I get the general idea that he's not effectively a Hannity or a Carlson, yeah, in terms of white supremacy and stuff like that. But I'm sure he's plenty conservative. But honestly, I probably don't respect a lot about his ideology, I do respect that, like, you can have someone from your party in power but be incredibly frustrated with them. Like, how much did, even before I was part of TYT, how much was TYT attacked for being critical of Obama?
Yeah.
But that's the job. It's not to become cheerleaders for 4 years and then hyper-partisan attack dogs for 4 years. You're supposed to know what your principles are and hold to them regardless of who currently occupies the Oval Office.
There's so many levels of that, as you mentioned. So if you don't become the attack dog versus like a lap dog back and forth, then even there's factions within your own party, which happens with conservatives obviously as well too. If you do it, suddenly you're like a never Trumper. I can't believe it, you got derangement syndrome. So they do all these, they give you these labels of being not real versions of whatever affiliation and political circles you're supposed to be a part of. Why are we affected by that so much? Yeah. Fine, call me a name, it's whatever, I'm telling you the truth.
Yeah, I wanna show just a little bit more from that Cavuto video.
Just like you never paid to silence a porn star until it turns out you did. Never ordered your former White House counsel Don McGahn to fire Bob Mueller until we learned you tried. Fake is when it's wrong, Mr. President, not when it's unpleasant. Just like it isn't and wasn't fake when you said the Access Hollywood tape wasn't real when it was, or that you inherited an oppression from Barack Obama when you didn't, or that you ripped quantitative easing when he was president, but are furious the Federal Reserve isn't doing the same for you now that you're president. Just because you're the leader of the free world doesn't entitle you to a free pass. Unfortunately, just a free press.
So what I love about that is not just that he was willing to stand against the president, but how much fun was Cavuto having during that segment? You could tell in each one of those, but you did. Like, there's just that little bit of fun in the closer, which was a good closer. Mm-hmm. He obviously enjoyed that. And apparently looking back now, because like I said, I missed this when it first happened. He was attacked by the president and had to do a sort of follow up, because that's the sort of thing that does not get you respect from conservatives for sticking to your principles. It gets you called a shill or whatever.
It sucks. But you know what, now after you say all that, after you go through all of the back and forth about he's a liar, he's misled us on this one, he's given us this point on that one. After that, we need to come to the conclusion, therefore, what else is he screwing up because of his approach to life, which is to lie and then lie and then lie. The problem, I don't watch Cavuto every day, but when you stop at that point, then you're not doing the full service. You go through everything he's done that's horrible and then go, okay.
Yeah.
So what's the point? You just expose him for exactly how blatantly false everything he says is. Mm-hmm. Then you go back on as if this is a normal approach to life.
Yeah, well, we'll check with him. We'll see what he's doing more recently. Might get fired. We'll find out after that. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.